guys, we're back with another video. If you are new here, my name is Sammy and we are the Mermaid Gang. This is where you can come and suspend your disbelief. I am your favorite manifestation coach. So, if you would like for me to help you dissolve whatever's between you and your manifestation, go ahead and check my site in the description box and see if I have anything available. If so, I would love to help you. Also, please go to that same site and check out the VIP group. It is where I will be doing more. I'll be putting in extra content and extra energy and interacting with you guys more now that I have started to cut back on coaching. So if you would like to be able to spend more time with me and my coaches and be able to ask questions and get help with whatever you need, the VIP group is where to go. Okay, let's get into the video. Let's talk about awareness. Your awareness. This is more Neville. Neville teaches awareness. But I'm going to break it down for you in Sammy terms. Your awareness is literally that, what you're aware of. Whatever you're aware of will be and stay in your reality. So, basically, let's say a really good example is an SP relationship with a 3P. So let's say you are manifesting your person, right? And there is a third person. The more you are aware of this person, this unwanted person, the longer they will remain in your reality. This is why when you guys say, I'm manifesting someone, but there's a 3P and I just can't get rid of them. I'm affirming them away. The thing is, affirming them away, I only do that in like really, really irritating circumstances when the person just cannot fucking stop thinking about them or noticing them. But my number one go-to thing is to take your awareness off of them. If you will stop being aware of this person, they will go away. Whatever you turn your attention away from, whatever you are no longer aware of, must go away. If you're not aware of it, it cannot be in your reality and it will go away. So therefore, if you will stop giving this person attention, they will go away. If you will simply affirm, if you would just simply affirm and think of your person as just with you, you think of them as it, you think as if it is just you and your person. Your manifestation should literally only be about you and your person, because as long as you are affirming for you and your person, and affirming yourself to be the version of you that is in a relationship with your person, then anything standing in the way of that must go. So that means there's no need for you to acknowledge or be aware of any obstacle. And that goes for any manifestation. Whatever you are aware of, whether it be lack of money, failing grades, shitty coworkers, shitty people, toxic people in general, problems in your life. Just some people just have problem after problem after problem. It's because you're aware. You're putting your awareness on these things. Instead, if you would just choose your affirmations, thinking as if you already have what you want, you're being aware of having what you want. You're being aware of this thing as if it is already in your life. So what you have to do is only be aware of the things that you want in your reality, the people that you want in your reality. Anything else must go. What's that show? Everything Must Go? Is that a show? Yeah, everything must go. Everything else must go. Only the things you want should be in your awareness. You should only have your attention on things that you want. You should only think of things that you want. If you think of something that you don't want, turn your attention away and back to what you do want. This goes back to what I said about redirecting before in my previous videos. Redirect your thoughts to what you want. Every time you're thinking and being aware of something you don't want, redirect your thoughts back to what you do want. Because the only things you should be aware of are the things that you do want. And the more that you are aware of the good things, the things you do want, the things that make you happy, the things that make you fulfilled, the more you're aware of your good qualities and your, because I told you, self-concept is forever. You should constantly be describing yourself as the person you want to be. So the more you're aware of these good qualities, the more you're aware of these good people, these good things, all the other shit will go away. Anything that you are no longer aware of will go away. Your awareness is what you have your attention on. The only thing that can reside in your reality is what you are aware of. So if there are things that you no longer want in your reality, you must turn your attention away. Don't think of them, don't acknowledge them, don't react to them, don't look at them, mentally or physically. Don't just turn your attention away. Bring yourself back to thinking of only the things that you want in your reality. Your awareness should only consist of the things that you want in your reality. If you will turn your attention away from all the other things, they will go away. Nothing can live in your reality if you're not aware of it. Only the things in your awareness can stay. So you get to choose. You get to choose what you're aware of. That is what awareness is. It's whatever you focus on is what grows or stays in your reality. And what you turn your attention away from must go away. If you don't think of it, if you don't acknowledge it, it doesn't exist in your reality anymore. It doesn't. Whether it's problems, bills, people, like I said, lack of money, whatever it is, third party, turn your attention away. Only affirm and think as if you have the things you want, and everything else will have to go away. That's the law. That is spiritual law. What you're aware of is the only thing that can exist in your reality. If you're not aware of it, it can't live in your reality. It's just not a part of it. It's not a part of your reality anymore. So it'll go away. Does that make sense? Okay. That's all I have to say about that. I think I was pretty clear. If you stay to the end of the video, let me know what you think the next VIP challenge should be. We just did self-concept / whatever you're manifesting. What challenge should we do in the VIP now? It's time to start a new challenge, and I want suggestions from you. What's the new VIP challenge? And I'll choose from your comments. Comment below and let me know what challenge we should do. Thank you so much for watching. Please be sure to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And we out.